Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. I'm Dr. Hina Khan, and today we're going to discuss a very significant and an important topic, which is known as the intracranial hemorrhages out there. So we usually come across these patients who present to you in the outpatient departments, and you have to treat them as physicians and clinicians. So you must be knowing the risk factors that can contribute towards the development of such condition, and what are the significant prognostic factors that again contribute towards the final outcomes of these patients of intracranial hemorrhages. Particularly in this lecture, we'll be moving on and discussing the types of the intracranial hemorrhages, mainly the epidural, we have the intracerebral, and finally we have the subdural hemorrhages that we'd be discussing out here, the major clinical manifestations. And how do you diagnose these patients? What are the risk factors that basically contribute towards the development of such conditions that would be discussed over here? We'd be considering the different etiological factors that contribute towards the development of such conditions, mainly the head trauma. We have the hypertensive hemorrhages, transformations of ischemic infarctions, specifically a lot of metastatic brain tumors, coagulopathies, and a lot of congenital conditions, even such as the malformations, aneurysms, and the amyloid angiopathies make the person at a risk of the development of such intracranial hemorrhages. We'd be discussing the non-contrast CT imaging. Moreover, I'll be discussing the emergency management. As a medical officer working in an emergency department, you must be knowing the steps to follow and how to receive such patients and how to manage such patients, how to maintain their airway, breathing, and circulation. What are the techniques? We'd be discussing all of that out here. Mainly the causative factors of the intracerebral hemorrhages would be discussed over here, the clinical manifestations of the hypertensive intracerebral hemorrhages, particularly the lobar hemorrhages and their clinical manifestations. And the other significant causes of the intracerebral hemorrhages would also be discussed over here. How do you evaluate such patients at the laboratory findings? What are the radiological investigations that are the main highlights for the diagnostic factors out there? And obviously, what are the acute management techniques that would be discussed over here in this lecture, ranging from the infusion of the different vitamin K and the other factors out there. So you can watch the detailed lecture and the other medical lectures on our website by subscribing to our website, and you can even start your free trial today. Thank you for watching sqadia.com.